Here we have this double integral, and we want to change the order of integration. So instead of integrating over y and then over x, we have to integrate first over x and then over y. How can we do that? Well, you can see that the coordinate y is contained in the interval 0 and sine x, whereas the x coordinate is between 0 and pi. So if we draw this region, we get this. So here we have x, here we have y, and here we have just one portion of a sinusoid between 0 and pi, and we have to integrate over this area here. So instead of integrating first over y, like this, and then moving horizontally like this, we want to change this order. So first we want to integrate like this, and then vertically. In order to do that, we need to be careful here, because the sinusoidal function, sine of x, in the region where x is between 0 and pi, it is not invertible. In particular, we have to cut it at x equal to pi over 2. So that we have two curves, this first one and this second one. So we have two regions where the function will become invertible. Why am I saying that? Well, because if I consider the line y equal to sine of x, if I consider x equal to the inverse of the sine, which is the arc sine, and I will write it as a sine of y. So if we write it like this, x is between minus pi over 2 and pi over 2. In particular, here, let me draw it like this. I have y here and x here. And this function is something like this. It goes all the way up to x equal to pi over 2 when y is equal to 1. So here we have pi over 2. Whereas here it goes down like this. Here we have x equal to minus pi over 2 at y equal to minus 1. So this portion here, when x is between 0 and pi over 2, describes this curve right here. But it does not describe this one, because as I just told you, this function can describe only the portion where x is between minus pi over 2 and pi over 2, so it describes also this portion here, but we are not interested in this one, because this is true for negative x's, and I'm not interested in those values. So we need to describe the first part and also the second part, this one here. So let's try to reason this out, where x, as I just told you, can be written as the inverse sine arc sine of y if x is between 0 and pi over 2. But I have to be careful when I want to describe this portion here. So I can do it in a few steps. It's quite simple, it's not so hard, but we have to be careful. So let's draw also these negative portion here, where x is between 0 and minus pi over 2. And if we change the sign of this one here, well, we are going to get something like this, which is symmetric with respect to the x-axis. And it is exactly equal to this one here, to this portion. But it is simply translated by pi. So here we can just simply write down minus a sine of y, and then we just simply have to add pi. So for example, if we set y equal to 1, we are here, and we should get x equal to pi over 2. From here we get, of course, pi over 2, because the inverse sine of 1 is equal to pi over 2. Whereas here, we get minus pi over 2 plus pi, which is still equal to pi over 2. So you can see that this is true. So this is true if x is between pi over 2 and pi. So it doesn't really matter if I consider this pi over 2 here and also here, because, for example, I can omit pi over 2 here. And when I use this bracket pointing outwards, I mean that this value is excluded in this first region, whereas it is included in this region because I am orienting this bracket like this. But I could also do it like this. For example, I could close the bracket like this, and then here I will point it outwards like that. It doesn't matter. So when we integrate first over x, we want to go from this portion of the curve all the way up to this portion of the curve. We are integrating actually from left to right. So the integral over x goes from a sine of y to pi minus a sine of y f of x y dx, and then I have dy, and y goes from 0 to 1. It's easy to see because we are moving from y equal to 0 here, and then we are going all the way up to y equal to 1. And this is the result.